In one of the earlier videos, I had shown how to build a multi-platform container image using the buildx feature of Docker. In that video, I used this platforms flag for creating Linux AMD64 and Linux ARM64 as two versions of the image based on a Docker file. Now, this is helpful if you have to build multi-platform images just for one project or one service. In a typical microservice-based application, you have multiple services which are related to one another, and you might have to build multiple of these microservices to build the whole application. Doing this for every microservice is a tedious task. There has to be a better way of doing it. In this video, we are going to see how to use Docker Compose and the feature of Docker Compose to build multi-platform images. Let's get started. I have this Compose file, which I use for building my Tech Talks application as part of the Cloud Native Ninja series. It has got two services, the Tech Talks producer and Tech Talks consumer. In the earlier version, I did not specify these platforms as a parameter. In this case, whatever is the operating system and the architecture of the processor used for that particular operating system, the image would be created using that. Now, in this case, I want to force the image creation to target two specific platforms. And that is where I can specify under the build parameter or the build context, which is used for building the container images, along with the things like context and the Docker file, which is used as normal parameters, this additional set of parameters called as platforms, and list all the platforms that I want to build the image for. In this case, I'm specifying Linux/AMD64 and Linux/ARM64. These are the same two platforms we had specified on the terminal using the buildx. And I do the same for Tech Talks consumer as well. Now let's go and trigger the build with this and see how does it behave. So if I run Docker images, you see that I don't have any image currently built for the Tech Talks producer and the consumer. And I'm going to use this Docker Compose command and use that file, the -f parameter, to specify Docker Compose Java Docker Hub .yml. And we are going to use build as the operation. When I trigger the build, we can see that it's pulling for the Tech Talks consumer and the Tech Talks producer, the ARM64 and AMD64 version of the base images. We can also verify this by going into the Docker, and in one of the earlier videos, I had shown how to use the new feature in Docker 4.26, which is the Docker builds, to see what is the ongoing builds. So if we head over to the dashboard here, we can see that the Tech Talks consumer and Tech Talks producer is currently being built, and it's being built for two platforms, AMD64 and ARM64. This is happening for both the images, the Tech Talks producer and Tech Talks consumer. And these two things are running in parallel. This will take some time because we don't have the images cached. It will pull all the dependencies from the Maven Central, and it will take maybe a couple of minutes to download all these things. I will come back once the build is completed, and we will see what is the result of this. And there we have our build completed. Let's go and run the Docker images command now, and we should be able to see the images which are generated or which are created as part of this. We can see the two versions of Tech Talks consumer, which was created about 33 and 36 seconds ago, and the producer was created about 50 seconds ago. These are the different tags that we have, AMD64 and ARM64. That is why we see four different images instead of just two images, which we see in normal case. So I hope this one is useful, where instead of typing the Docker build and specifying the platform on command line every time, we can use this as part of Docker Compose to simplify the build process, which will help us to build multiple images using one single command. Hopefully you found this video useful. In case you know any better way of doing the same thing, please let me know in the comments. Assuming you found the video useful, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. If you want to get notified, please hit the like button. Please hit the bell icon, which will give you notifications when the new videos are published on the channel. Thanks for watching this. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.